Hey guys, this is Morgan from Mass Photo, and today I'm going to show you how to create smartphone wallpaper using Adobe Photoshop CC and the Artboards feature. Now this is a fairly easy thing to do, so let's begin. To start, we're going to go up to File, then we're going to click New, and then right here where it says Document Type, you want to make sure that Artboard is selected. Then Artboard size, there's a bunch of different options. I'm going to pick iPhone 6 Plus because that's what I will be working on today. All right, then once that's all selected, press OK. This new artboard pops up, and I'm going to show you something really quick. Over here in the Layers panel where it says Artboard 1, I'm going to name that iPhone 6 Plus. All right, and that is going to make life easier. If you want to work with multiple files at once, all you have to do is click and drag. The artboard tool should already have been selected. So now you have artboard 2. You can change the template for that guy right here, over here in the size dropdown. So I already have 6 Plus open. I'm going to click iPhone 6 for this one. And I will name that iPhone 6. This makes it so you can work with multiple different kinds of layouts simultaneously, which makes life a lot easier. And I'm gonna delete that right now, but I thought that I would show you. You can even export all your artboards with one button. Just go to File, Export, and you can save every single one of them at the same time. So it's a pretty cool feature. But anyways, here we go. I'm going to open up the picture that I would like to use for the wallpaper, and I believe I have that right here. Yes, this is a picture I took in the Upper Peninsula last year, so with, alright, so we're just going to click and drag that into our artboard, and it's quite a bit bigger than the artboard, so I'm going to zoom out just a little bit and resize this. That looks good, and cool. That looks pretty cool. To double check and make sure the dimensions are correct, the templates I was talking about earlier, I'm gonna actually open one of them up. I have right here for the 6S Plus. I just made these for you guys. I'm gonna click and drag it onto the artboard. I'm gonna line it all up. All right, that looks good, and I'm just gonna check the opacity. Take that down a little bit so I can kind of see through it and make sure that nothing is in the way, because the app dock on your phone, that little square at the bottom with the four apps, that's going to kind of hide up or it's going to hide your image a little bit. So to prevent that, I made you guys a little safety template right here. You just kind of click the eyeball on and off to make sure that in the little space at the bottom, that nothing that you care about is getting covered up. Alright, sorry about that guys. My computer froze up for a second, but we are back. Anyways, back to what I was saying. I've made you guys all templates for all the iPhones, and I'm currently working on the Android version. It's just kind of a little safety net, I guess, to make sure that nothing's getting covered up by the app tray in the bottom of your iPhone or anything that that Android might have. Let's see. So I clicked and I dragged the template over this picture, and you can see the opacity. There you go, at 100. So this black spot right here, that's where your app tray is located. So you can kind of click and the eyeball on and off and compare where what that part's covering up in the document. Alright, so now that I see the tree and everything is gonna be right above the app tray, I think that looks fine. It's a nice little hill with the tree and the Milky Way. I'll just click the template off. I'm happy with that, and then it's time to save it. To save it you just go to File, Export, and then you click on Artboards to Files. This file prefix name, I'm going to call it iPhone 6 Plus. Lost is the name of that image, so I'll just put lost at the end of it. And then right here it says include overlapping areas. You just want the artboard content only. And I export as JPEG. Quality, I set that to 12. And I click on the include ICC profile right here underneath quality. And then you can pick the destination that you would like to save it at. I'll just save it to my desktop for now. Click OK. And then click the run button. There you go. That is how you create smartphone wallpaper in Photoshop CC.